Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the NXT versus SmackDown Battleground Draft. I am the NXT General Manager, and after Sunday, I will be the full-time General Manager of SmackDown as well. I am the future.
So cocky. Regardless, I apologize for my absences recently. I've been busy.
Air quotes.
I'm being serious. I've been busy getting the team leader ready and pumped up. I
AKA personal reasons.
Anyways.
This is the draft. We decided we're going to shake things up. We're going to do it. We're going to start it here. We're going to have 8 rounds. 10 people per round. Rules of the draft. NXT gets first pick, obviously. Tag teams and factions count as one draft pick. If one of us chooses for somebody in that said team or faction to not be drafted, then it is your call to do so. Another note I'd like to make is we are currently not drafting any women or any cruiserweights.
Due to the undecided
stipulations of Sunday's matches.
Yes.
So this is round one. This is gonna be split into 8 parts. Okay. So, the first person I'm going to draft is AJ Styles, just like I did when we started this program.
No problem.
Would you like to take a look at the roster, or do you have somebody in mind already? Let me just pop AJ up here.
I don't mind taking a look.
The first 3 tabs.
Alrighty. I'll draft Batista.
The heart and soul of SmackDown.
Indeed.
Batista, former 3-time SmackDown champion. By the way, what'd you think of Great Balls of Fire? I didn't get your opinion. You weren't here.
It was alright.
Are you proud of your new champ? The champ is here.
Indeed. I missed the women's belt because I had to head to the store, but yeah.
Alexa retained her title, of course.
Yeah. Which I read the chat.
I think my next draft pick's going to be my tag team. He's already exempt.
Can't draft. He's already exempt.
I'm going to draft the Viper, Randy Orton. Let me go pop those up on the screen. Europe.
Alrighty.
Feel free to scroll. You're on SmackDown's current page right now.
Okay.
It's touchscreen. You could just use your finger.
Yeah, I don't really think about that. All right. Even though this competitor has only wrestled on SmackDown once, I'm already impressed. Bobby Roode.
The glorious Bobby Roode. Not a bad choice. Perhaps a future champion?
I foresee it. It's a possibility, a good possibility, a glorious possibility. I was going to plug it in anyways, so yeah.
My next pick might shock you. My next pick has been rated R for ridiculousness, redonkulousness, and most importantly, because he's the rated R superstar. I'm going with Edge.
All right. It would suck to see him go, but at the same time, let's think of it.
He's out of your hair now. Not that you were feuding still, but he's out of your hair now. Now you don't have to worry about it ever happening again. As of right now.
Let's think about it this way. Jimmy's there currently, and
now Edge is here. Well, Jimmy's not here. Well, he's here currently, but he hasn't been drafted yet. It's possible he can go to SmackDown.
Yeah, I don't plan on drafting him.
He just came to NXT. That would be a shame if they had to jump back to SmackDown. Anyways.
All right. So.
Draft number 6.
All right. Alrighty. You got a shocker. I got a shocker. Finn Balor.
Of course, these... I want to clarify something here. The draft will go into effect starting next Thursday on SmackDown. Which means it doesn't affect what goes on Sunday. They're still representing their brand, their current brand, Sunday. The draft officially goes into effect next Thursday.
Indeed.
So, Balor of the Balor Club. You know, that's going to be pretty interesting. With the Bullet Club, Civil War. Might be a casualty.
Maybe.
Alright, let's pop that up there. There, you do it.
Alright. Right.
They got a drop down arrow. Put the second one.
Doesn't matter which one in the end.
Not really, but second one. Okay. It's time for drafty number 8. You may say that he's a great, but you better watch it because he's the best in the world at everything he does, and that's why he wears those 4 letters on his trunks. Of course, I'm talking about the greatest of all time, the GOAT, Y2J, Chris Jericho.
Good pick. All right. My pick is a literal GOAT. And I'm talking about Daniel Bryan.
Ooh. I mean... I see brighter paths for him. Daniel Bryan gonna split with Kane. Go ahead, you can draft him. Let's see. you know, I didn't want to do this, but I feel like you would be much better with me making this decision to draft the following than for them to remain here on SmackDown. You might disagree with it, partially because they're already in a match on Sunday. A big match. I'm drafting the team of American Alpha.
No problem. I had no problem with that, actually.
That's going to be interesting. Considering that that's half of Team SmackDown right there. Now, due to the draft rules, you have to pick a tag team or faction as well.
How about the club?
As in Gallows and Anderson?
Yeah.
That's fine. You know, you can't draft the rated R superstar without Captain Charisma. I'm going to draft Christian. Oh, yeah, we got to put those up there. Okay, so. Jason Jordan Angle. Chad Gable. And then Christian. All right, you may draft your club, Gallows and Anderson.
All right, I know it's my pick. Another guy I obviously plan on keeping. Shinsuke Nakamura.
You don't want to lose all of Team SmackDown now, do you? Shinsuke Nakamura hasn't been in action very much recently, but he could be the ace in the hole for Sunday, Team SmackDown.
Who knows?
We got two more drafts each in this round. So I think it's time to go big or go home. You might question this one. But my next pick is not just a man. He's a dead man walking. I'm drafting The Undertaker.
Even though we still won't see him in action.
I don't know where The Undertaker is, okay? But I draft The Undertaker.
Alright, as long as you have him come out to Kid Rock's American Badass, we're good. I'm joking. But maybe. I'm joking. Maybe. Either way, we're good.
I reckon it's your boy Borg Laser over there. Get your boy, Roman Reigns. That's going to be your main event.
Or what Heyman calls.
No, it's Vince's main event. Shane being backstage was completely random.
To be honest, I think Rowan getting arrested was random.
I was just, it was to give you, it was supposed to make sympathy. Because he was defenseless.
To be honest, you can't.
See, had Brock not. We're watching the WWE Network right now, getting ready to watch Hall of Fame while recording this. And they're playing the build-up for WrestleMania. Basically, if Brock didn't. Brock hesitated with the chair. If he didn't hesitate, he wouldn't have taken 3 Superman punches.
Just saying, though, you can't treat the Superman punch like if it's hot shit. It's not hot shit.
It's just a jumping punch to the face.
Anyone could do that. Hell, I could do that with Steven Tekken, damn it.
No. You could also,
And it's quite effective, too.
You could also do a Trish Stratus move. The Matrix.
Yeah.
All right. Back to the draft now.
Yeah, totally.
Now that we're off topic.
Yeah. You're probably gonna call me crazy on this one. Well, this man has kids.
Are you saying what I think you're saying? Are you telling me you want to walk with Slater?
I'll walk with Slater.
Okay, then. Well, so much for Jinder Mahal coming back to get it, Slater. It was Slater that put the final nail in the coffin for him on Saturday. Before Christian got the ultimate win.
Yeah, Christian may have gotten the ultimate win, but Slater.
It was Slater's pinfall that put him down below 2 falls. Heath Slater. What's he gonna do? Job out to Kenny Omega?
No. No, I'm the type of guy that that's willing to give people chances. If he can prove himself, he'll get a title shot. It's that simple.
I see.
And taking out Jinder Mahal like that. Basically threatening the fabric of Mahal's career there. Some props there.
Hey, there's Samoa Joe. I was wondering where Joe's been. Hey, Big Daddy Cool! I'm half tempted to turn the volume on, but I know I can't because we're recording this.
Yeah.
Don't worry, it'll be on the network afterwards. Anyways.
Yeah, true. All right.
My last pick for round one. He's the man. Seth! Frickin' Rollins. Open my door real quick.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, mother. I found Joe. I found Joe. He's getting talked to on the red carpet.
On the red carpet?
Yeah.
Yeah, rumor has it Joe might be Strowman's
Listen, there's so many people. Why? You know who I've been hearing since yesterday? Batista.
Yeah, I've heard that one.
That one, like, skyrocketed since yesterday.
Oh, my God. That would be insane if that's the case.
That ain't gonna happen.
It won't happen.
It won't happen. He's got movie premiere coming up.
Yeah, but the big old question here is, what about that rumor that Drax is going to die?
And Drax is going to get his own movie, plus the Infinity Stone.
Knowing Drax?
Hey, there's the New Day!
Yeah.
Who's SmackDown's last draft for round one? He's not wearing any socks.
It's not every day to do that.
Is that Ryan Seacrest? I'm joking.
I was going to say, it would not surprise me if he's there.
I was joking, though.
I know, but it wouldn't be a surprise. I mean, there's a bunch of celebrities that show up. I mean, hell, Kid Rock.
He's in the Hall of Fame class of 2018!
Exactly! So he's obviously going to be there.
Oh, there's Asuka. Can't miss her with her bright pink and blue hair. Looks like every other Jap, minus the hair color.
Oh, god damn it. That's not true.
So true.
It's sad. I could tell what they were saying there because they've done it so many times.
It's Alexa! I'm turning the volume on.
He can turn the volume on. I'm going to make an educated draft pick here.
How are you doing?
I'm fantastic. How are you?
I'm excellent. And this is only your second Hall of Fame.
Yes. Last year was my first Hall of Fame, and I brought my mother, and this year she's with me again this year. Nice. So it's a lot of fun. Our new tradition.
And you're running on caffeine. They got you so busy here, huh?
Yes, caffeine and concealer is what I always say.
Ready for your match at Mania?
I am. I'm very excited. I'm so ready to have Sunday come here, and I'm pumped.
So, I want to lay it straight here. I mean, you say you're excited, but you are taking on your former best friend, one of the most feared women we've ever seen here in WWE, and Nia Jax.
Yes, that is correct. My former BFF.
And are you confident about this?
So here's the thing, when you're facing your best friend or former best friend, obviously there is, you know, a height difference and a strength difference between Nia Jax and I, so I have to have a different approach. If I cannot, you know, beat her down physically, I have to do it mentally, because we are best friends, and I know her weaknesses.
I was just going to say, you got to know her weaknesses. Well, okay, so but, can you share what her weaknesses are?
Like, I gotta use that for the match.
Shin's an issue. What is it?
Hold on. I want to take a step back here, and I'm gonna put you on the spot here. Was Nia really ever your best friend, or was it just a ruse all along?
How dare you, Byron? Everything I've ever said is from the bottom of my heart.
And with that,
I'm not trying to get on her bad side.
Good luck on Sunday. We're gonna throw it over to Renee.
Whatever. Okay.
That's Bailey's husband. Oh my gosh, she doesn't have a ponytail.
I know, it's so, I know, I could tell you for certain. Yeah, so different compared to most of the time. But yeah, my last pick will probably be, this one will be fun, but yeah. James Storm.
The Cowboy. Another guy who's only had one match. A battle royal.
Let's not forget. I got the beer and I got the money.
You don't even drink.
I'm not actually talking about actual beer. Man. My attempt at making a beer money reference. Going down the drain. Alright, so anyways.
That's all we got for round one. Yes, anything you want to say before we cut it here? Happy Rusev Day, everybody!
Well, there's that. Regardless, though,
Quad Tear City.
Man, just saying, though, the Hall of Fame.
Speaking of beer.
Stone Cold.
All right, anything to say?
Nothing much, really. Regardless, there will probably be more coming up. So
tune in to round two.
Stay tuned.